Hi everyone, this is Rich of the Rich Maxwell channel. Welcome back. This video is about lenses for the Sony full frame mirrorless cameras. So I'm going to talk through the lenses I've purchased, and these lenses are all budget friendly options. Not a rich professional photographer, so couldn't afford some of the Sony native lenses, as found they were extremely expensive, so that's led me to look into the budget alternatives. And in this video I'm going to talk about these the options that I picked. So even though they're budget lenses, they take great professional photos, really superb quality photos. So I'm going to talk through the options here. And if you find the content interesting, please do give it a like and consider subscribing to my channel for more videos like this about photography gear, drones, and even talking about fitness from time to time. So yeah, please join me for more videos. So onto the lenses then. So I'm going to go through my top three picks of lenses. I've bought several lenses actually for this camera. So I've got seven altogether. And so I'm going to talk about the three that I think are the most useful to have in your equipment gear. So first of all then, I'm going to talk about a third party manufacturer lens that's a native E-mount lens. This is the Viltrox 85mm f1.8. So 85mm is a fantastic focal length for portraits, and at 1.8 that means you can get a nice blurred out background, so it's a really nice lens to have. It's really sharp and it's a very well built lens. It's like solid metal, feels really heavy to hold, so it looks like it's built to last. And so far I've taken some great images with it, so I'm going to show a few of the portraits that I've taken. They should be coming up on screen now. And yeah, so that's my first recommendation. So after you've got the camera with the kit lens, get a beautiful portrait lens, 85mm f1.8. This I picked up for £265. The Sony equivalent is around about £550, so about twice as much. So buying this third party Viltrox lens has saved a ton of money there. So that's a highly recommended lens. Next up, gonna talk about adapted lenses. As I use a Yongnuo EF-E2 lens adapter so that I can use Canon lenses. So this adapter I have done a review about, but that's basically it. So it's a really nice adapter, works really good with lots of different lenses and gets USB updates, so it's constantly updated to take different lenses. That's great. So with this adapter, it enables me to use all the Canon full frame lenses. So I bought a few of these. So first one that I bought, which is in my top three lenses that I recommend, is this 17-40mm f4L. So this lens is primarily, I bought it for landscape photography. So it's a nice wide angle lens. It takes really nice sharp images. And picked this up on eBay used for £190. It had a slight fault with the front filter part having a chip in it, but I fixed that. And so great value. With the repair that I had, the part that I had to buy to repair it, it's cost me £220. On eBay you can regularly find these for about £300, £350, but the Sony equivalent is I think it's about £1,200 for the Sony 15 or 16-35mm lens. So this is a great alternative with a lens adapter, takes beautiful photos. The only drawback with a lens adapter is that it doesn't seem to work for video in terms of autofocus, but for photos, it focuses just like a native lens, really fast and really sharp. So I highly recommend that one as the next lens in my top three. Next up, I recommend a telephoto lens. So this one is a 70-200 Sigma 2.8, f2.8. So at f2.8 and this sort of focal length, you can take really nice portraits with really beautiful blurred out backgrounds, as well as zoomed in photos of like animals at zoos and farms. I'm going to show a few of those images here. Hope you like those. So yeah, that's the next lens that I recommend. This one I picked up for £250, the Sony equivalent 70-200. I believe it's well over a grand. I think it's about £1,500. So this with an adapter is a massive saving, as it works just like a native lens for focusing for photos, but video won't work. But realistically, I can't see myself wanting to shoot video at 70-200. So for video, I've got my kit lens, and attached to the camera right now is a 50mm f1.8. That's a native Sony lens. So yeah, I highly recommend getting a telephoto. This one doesn't have image stabilization, There are some alternatives you could look at. You can get a Tamron f2.8 70-200 or a Canon L lens, either an f4 or an f2.8. I recommend the f2.8 so that you can get that nice bokeh blurred out backgrounds. So yeah, definitely go for an f2.8. Doesn't matter about image stabilization because the camera, the Sony full frame cameras, all of them from A7 to upwards have inbuilt stabilization. So you don't need to spend loads to get the stabilization in the lens. So that's why I bought this one. So great lenses there. With the kit lens, you've got all focal lengths covered there from 17 millimeters up to 200. So you can do a wide range of photography. And yeah, take some great sharp photos. So hope this video is useful. Gonna talk about just a few other lenses that I've bought. I've got a 35mm Yongnu lens, which is a Canon mount. So this was just 50 quid. It works great with the adapter. Nice lens to use for sort of general photos indoors if you're in a small room. And it's nice and sharp at f2. It gives nice sort of blurred bokeh in the background. So that's a nice lens to pick up as well. Works great with the adapter. Also got a Canon 24-105 lens, f4L. This lens I bought thinking I'd replace my kit lens with it as a more wider range of a focal length there, but doesn't work for video with an adapter. So it's no use to me. I'm probably gonna sell that one. And also, as I say, got the 50mm f1.8 Sony lens on the camera. So that's a lens that I'm now using for my video vlogs. So hopefully this is coming up with some nice sharp images here and looking good on the screen for you guys. But yeah, that's another good lens to pick up on as a budget option. The Nifty 50, they call it. So on the Sony E-mount system, it's around about 150 quid. And yeah, that's a nice starter lens to pick up after you've got your camera and kit lens. So hopefully you've enjoyed this video. Please like, subscribe, and join me again. Thanks, guys. Have a great day.